Good afternoon. Welcome to UpPhront Radio. My name is Warren Michaels, and I will be your host. This afternoon's special guest is Charmian Devi. Born in Montreal, Canada, Charmian Devi has been an original singer-songwriter for many years. Formerly the founder and lead singer of the punk band Wretched Ethyl, formed in Vancouver, Canada, this band released two independent CDs and toured extensively across North America. Following Wretched Ethyl, there was a notable alternative rock band, L.I.A.R, formed in London, UK. The band performed in London clubs for 2 years. Devi has since formed a new duo with collaborator John Lok, writing soulful and melodic alternative pop songs. They are now currently in the music placement division at Gotham Records in Los Angeles for non-exclusive licensing opportunities. Now, please, let's give a warm welcome to Charmian Devi. Good afternoon, Charmian.
Good afternoon, Warren.
So nice to have you on the show today.
That's so great to be here, Warren. Thank you for having me.
Oh, you're more than welcome. Let's get started here, and let's talk about how you got started in a career in music.
Well, I started way back many, many, many years ago in art school in Montreal. I was going fine arts and painting and photography, and I started drumming, actually. So I drummed for a band there in Montreal, and then it just led to the guitar, and then I've been songwriting since then. And I've had many formations, as you just quoted on that little thing there, and I've just kept at it, and I just love it.
Very good. I was just checking the sound just now. I have a chat room open, and the people are starting to pile in now.
Okay.
Maybe as we talk, someone could ask questions. There's a few people in there.
Sure.
So tell me, I mentioned a couple of bands during the introduction.
Yes.
Could you tell us a little bit more about that, a little bit more in depth of that part of your career?
Well, it's probably the most prominent band that I formed myself. I was lead singer and front person with Wretched Ethyl. And we were quite a heavy-duty punk band that was together for 4 years out of Vancouver, Canada. And we toured all across North America, and we went down to the Whiskey Go-Go in L.A., and it was a super good time. We had a great response with both CDs, and actually one of them is in rare CDs. And then after that, I went solo for a while, and then I went to London, UK for a bit, and then I came back, and I formed this recent, the songs you have now, I formed with John Lok here in Canada, and there we are.
And here we are right now.
Here we are right now.
And now you have this with John Lok.
Yeah, John Lok.
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 I butcher all kinds of names.
I'm sorry. I don't mind.
Well, it's a toss-up. So, you know, someone would say, if I would have said Lok, somebody would have said no, Lok. I don't know. So what are your influences as far as music and your feelings toward music, your spirituality?
Well, I really have had quite a spiritual journey in the last 5 to 6 years. It's very hard to really explain it, but very sort of deep, meditative, quite alone and isolated. And through that time, I was listening a lot to Johnny Cash and Neil Young tremendously. And then Bob Dylan came in as well. And really, really listened to these songs a lot. And it just went right straight through me into my soul. And it just completely influenced this writing that I have now on this new EP called Karma Cell.
Yeah, well, those particular artists, they transcend music. They're just so, when they perform, they're just meaningful. You know, the music takes a second, it sort of like takes a second seat to the actual content.
Yeah, to me, it's almost as though the music just comes through them. And I mean, even Bob Dylan used to refer to that, how he couldn't even understand how he wrote certain songs. It just came right through him. And you can feel that when you listen to his music.
Yeah. Same with Neil Young. Neil Young had that same simple gift.
It's a simple gift, exactly, Warren. I totally appreciate that comment.
It is. It's very basic.
It's very, very basic. And but, it's funny you mention that, because that's very much what I was drawn to.
But isn't that the most difficult thing to attain? Something very, very basic and rudimentary rather than something complicated?
Yes.
I mean, we tend to complicate our music.
Yes.
And then you get a guy like Neil Young that puts out a song, Heart of Gold.
Yes.
It's just so simple.
Yes.
And when he performs it, he sings it as though he could care less what anybody's thinking.
Well, exactly. That's,
you know what I mean?
Beauty of Neil Young.
Exactly. Yeah.
I totally agree on that one, Warren. It's funny you mentioned that. We must be really synced up, because that's really what has really moved me through these last 5 years is that beauty. It really is that. There's a tremendous beauty in that simplicity and free spirit. It's like a real free spirit.
I know I have a lot of problems with that myself. It's just I'm just constantly looking a little bit too deeply at something and complicating it with such, you know, the music's too complicated, and then I just put it away because I get lost in it.
I've done that too. I went through a period of that, and then I think when you're really, I've been very spiritually tested, and I think when you're very tested, you have to let go of a lot of ego. And I think that's what happened to me. Yeah.
I have a song here that I know that I went to your website just how it started, and I spotted this song. I'm listening to it called Such a Disgrace. And
yes.
I immediately fell in love with it. So I'd like to play that right now. Okay, Charmian?
Okay, thank you. I'd just like to say I want to devote that actually to the women and children in the Democratic Republic of Congo that are experiencing tremendous grief from violent attack that just occurred 3 weeks ago.
Okay, we're going to talk more about that when we come back after the song is completed, okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome, Jim.
Just a bucket of fear. Well, who can blame who? I don't really care, 'cause you don't care at all. No offense, but it's true.
know, that song there is exactly that. It's exactly like a Neil Young song or a
Bob Dylan song.
Yeah, it's exactly like the same. It's the same genre, sure.
Thanks,
yeah.
Warren. Appreciate that. Did that sound? I hope that sounded pretty good on your
I
side.
I asked the chat room. It said sounds fine.
Okay, good.
Yeah, you can't go by the monitoring service here. They don't, you know, feed it back to you. As a matter of fact, it's because of me, I think. I made them put faders in here. They just had on and off.
Oh, okay.
You know.
It sounded good.
I bothered them for years to put faders. They finally did it. There's a few people in the chat, and let's talk more about this foundation or this
So it's called the Congo Yet To Initiative, and mm-hmm. it's here in Ottawa, Canada, and it was started by a man called Desiree Kolowa. He came from the eastern part of the Democratic Republic of Congo, and his story is just absolutely incredible. He started helping these women that were being raped, en masse attacks by the militia group in the Congo. He started very slowly, one by one, building up, helping these women in his house. He got so big that he began a shelter and providing medical help. He got a partner with the United Nations, and so providing medical help and shelter for these women that had been massive. I don't know if you know how bad it is, but it's very, very, very bad. And so from there, he had one woman that was raped by a policeman. And so he went down to the police station, reported it, and the policeman was arrested, went to jail for 3 days, got out, came to Desiree's house with 6 policemen and tried to kill him. So he got out of the Congo with a United Nations visa. He's been in Canada for 2 years and started the organization here. And we are supremely trying to raise funds because it is still very, very bad in the Congo. There was just an attack 2 weeks ago in the same part, Eastern Democratic Republic of Congo. 121 women raped, a village pillaged, completely destroyed. And it's an extremely bad situation. So if you want to donate funds, you can go to www.congoyettu.org. So it's Congo, C-O-N-G-O, Yettu, Y-E-T-U.org. And please donate anything you can. Thank you.
Okay. All right. So if you have any, we have 90 seconds left. Maybe you'd like to say if you're on CD Baby or give them your website.
Sorry, my website or?
Yes. Or wherever they can purchase your music.
Oh, okay. So if you go to www.charmiandevi.com and I am on CD Baby. And I actually don't have the address on me, but all the information is on my website page, charmiandevi.com.
All right.
Yeah.
Plus, I'm going to make that video. Inside that video, I'll put all your information. Okay?
No, that's great, Warren.
Yeah, I'll work on that today, and I'll send you the link. I'll send you the file. Okay?
That's fantastic. Thanks so much, Warren.
You're more than welcome, Sean. Give me some information about this cause also. I'll also promote that.
Oh, that's great, Warren. I'll send you something via email, I guess.
Thank you. Now it's time to say goodbye. And let me tell you, it was very nice and easy speaking with you. And anytime you want to do this again, you just let me know. Good night, Sean.
Thank you.